So they only have two pictures. Caretakers. that are against him, and you know, they're all that Show. There's a particular character. It's a white guy, kind of overweight, but in a strange way, like as if he has a pillow as the stomach and a very large face, as if he's wearing a mask and he wears a hat. This character would appear on the days that Michael was not at rehearsal, just sort of watching what the dancers were doing and whatnot. And this guy was also at the funeral sitting with the family. So they say that this was Michael secretly in disguise. The thing is, there is a photograph. I wish I had it in front of me, but I don't. There's a photograph of Michael that one of his brothers, not Jermaine, it was one of the, I can't remember the guy's name. It was one of the other, not the older brothers, one of the younger brothers, said that he was once at Tower Records in the late 70s. And there was a white guy standing next to him, looking at albums, who sort of kept nudging him. And he turned, and then this guy started talking to him. And he found out later that this old white guy was wearing a mask. It was Michael as a kid, so he had this setup or this getup, this disguise as this old white guy, like a chubby old white guy. That he had been using since the 70s, and then this character also appeared in both of those, in the audience in This Is It, and then at the funeral. So a lot of people say that he just kind of realized his music career wasn't going anywhere, that he wasn't maybe able to do concerts anymore, so he would, you know, he had a fairly large back catalog of songs, and Isa State, I think, got the rights to many of those songs, and that he would make, you know, he was able to recover, you know, what he had lost over the years by doing it this way. This is what the claims are. The thing is, his estate has made more money. They made like $200 or $300 million within the first month, I think, and definitely within the first year after the alleged death. So I don't know, people that have said that he's living in Bahrain, and there are these images which look like him in a burqa. I mean, look, I know people Photoshop things, and there's no way to tell if he did something like this. It's very possible, but you know, I have no idea. There's another guy called I think his name is Jason Malachi. He's a white guy. I think they said he's a police officer. This guy sings like Michael, but he does it in a strange way. He comes out, and it looks like he's lip syncing, but it's exactly Michael's voice. And it's weird. He just goes to like schools and kids' concerts and stuff, and then just starts singing like Michael Jackson. And they said that they used him, this guy Malachi, as the backup, the vocals on some of the unfinished albums, you know, some of the unfinished records that Michael had in his catalog. So that's another suspicious story. Like, is this his cover that through this guy he sends in recordings? That's what people claim. I mean, there's so many conspiratorial rumors about Michael Jackson. It's unbelievable. Many of those come out of Europe, though, because there's just a continuing interest in his, you know, life, and his music must have played on their radio stations much longer than it did over here in the, you know, North America. There's a very fast turnaround, so like people are mega famous for like 3 to 5 years, and then a new, you know, wonder comes along. And Michael experienced this in the 80s, but it was very hard for him to recuperate, and then those scandals just totally, you know, he couldn't recover from them. So even though like his decisions were as he grew.